Hello, my dear curious and studious students of surgery. Myself, Dr. Mahesh Chaudhary. I am warm welcoming you in my surgery lecture series. This surgery lecture series contains entire surgery with anesthesia, with radiology, with orthopedic. So stay tuned with us. Let's start our surgery lecture series. Welcome, dear students. In my surgery lecture number 89, that is the Raynaud's syndrome and Berger's disease. In this lecture, we will cover the Raynaud's syndrome, the clinical features of the Raynaud's syndrome and its treatment, thoracic outlet syndrome and its management, Berger's disease, that is the TAO, thromboendotitis obliterans, and its management. All these points are covered in this lecture. First, we start with the Raynaud's syndrome. This syndrome is firstly described by the Maurice Raynaud, described in 1862. That's why it's called the Raynaud's phenomenon. Is the primary disorders. Now the pathophysiology, arterioles penetrate the dermis at right angle with an irregular reticulate pattern and end in capillary network. Vasospasm, dermal circulation momentarily ceases and pallor, capillaries, venules dilate to the hypoxia of the limbs, upper arms, upper limbs. Accumulation of metabolic products of the regional anaerobic metabolism, products regional anaerobic metabolism is there. Slight relaxation of the arterial spasm, entry of small amount of blood into the dilated capillaries. This is the rapidly deoxygenated rise to the cyanosis, and cyanosis takes place. Redness or the rubor, vasodilatation develops due to the accumulation of the tissue metabolite during the anoxic period and produces the redness, that is the rubor. Here is the image on your screen. It is clearly showing the fingers is faint, pallor due to the vasospasm, dermal circulation momentarily ceases. Now this is the same image, but the dorsal side is there, and here is the cyanosis clearly seen. The bluish fingertips, the pulps of the fingers is clearly seen. The theory behind this Raynaud's syndrome is, there is a two theories. First is the alpha 2 adrenergic receptors are present in the form on B human platelets, and elevation of alpha 2 receptors activity is spastic, that is the Raynaud's disease. And theory number 2, that is the precipitate to the exposure to the cold. Clinical features of this disease is environmental, cold damp climate, occupation, use of the liberation tools, saw, operators. Three stages with exposure to the cold. First is the stage of the local syncope, second is the stage of the local asphyxia, and the third is the stage of the recovery. First, we will see the stage of the local syncope. Digital arterioles go into the spasm, decrease the blood flow, becomes pallor or blanching, starts at the tip of the fingers, gradually spread towards the base. Second stage is the stage of the local asphyxia with gradual warming, slight relaxation of the arterioles, blood passes, slowly flowing blood deoxygenated, cyanose, the stage of the dusky anoxia, fingers remain cold and numb. Now the third stage is the stage of the recovery. As the attack passes off, with more warming, spasm disappears and arterioles relaxes. Finger become red and swollen. Stages of the red engorgement. This is the stage of the red engorgement. Burning sensation and pain due to the increased tissue tension in the digits, means fingers. Now the examinations. First, the inspection, fingertip ulceration due to the obstruction and spasm of the arterioles. And on the palpation, fingers and hand feel cold. Pulse at the wrist are usually normal. One must exclude other conditions which may associate with this disease, that is the thoracic outlet syndrome, cervical rib, scleroderma, atherosclerosis, etc. Finger gradually waste, especially the pulp thin and pointed. Small scar may appear, painful ischemic ulcers, skin necrosis, repeated infection, paronychia, painful and slow to heal, rest pain and gangrene of the fingertips. Now the special investigation is to be done in the Raynaud's disease are digital plethysmography with digital blood pressure determination, arteriography, hemoglobin, ESR, rheumatoid factors, antinuclear antibody determination, and a protein electrophoresis. Now treatment. Conservative treatment should be tried first. Conservative treatment includes the moving to the warm climate, tobacco should be avoided, the part should be protected from the exposure to the cold, occupational exposure should be reduced. Variety of the vasodilator drugs have been used in this condition, like reserpine, intra-arterial and orally, methyl-dopa orally, guanethidine, phenoxybenzamine, prazosin and pentoxifilin, adrenergic blocking drugs. And the calcium channel blockers also been used, that is the nifedipine, potent peripheral vasodilator. Operative treatment in the Raynaud's disease, the cervical dorsal sympathectomy recommended in the primary Raynaud's disease. This is the good immediate result, produces long-term good results in the spastic Raynaud's disease. No benefit in Raynaud's syndrome with connective tissue diseases. Approach, there is a three types of the approach for performing this cervical dorsal sympathectomy. One is the anterior approach, that is the half inch above the clavicle incision to be made, and the second is the axilla, medial wall to axilla at the level of the second rib, and third approach is the posterior least, but this is the least popular. Now here is a diagram showing the cervicothoracic sympathectomy through the anterior approach. You can see the skin incision for the cervical sympathectomy. There is a phrenic nerve, subclavian artery, the scalene anterior is divided transversely, phrenic nerve drawn medially, there is a pleura is by the side, subclavian artery, Cibrissons fascia is broken through with the finger, taking care not to tear the underlying pleura. The sympathetic chain is divided between the third and fourth ganglion is clearly seen in the lowermost diagram. Now the next point of this lecture is the thoracic outlet syndrome. The thoracic outlet syndrome is the collective name which includes the cervical rib syndrome, salinus anticus syndrome, costoclavicular syndrome, hyperabduction syndrome, pectoralis minor syndrome, and the first thoracic rib syndrome. This thoracic outlet syndrome is caused by the compression of the brachial plexus and the subclavian artery or the vein in the region near the thoracic outlet. Symptoms may arise from the neural vascular or combined compression. Compression exists firmly in intersaline triangle. Etiology, first is the cervical rib occurs approximately 1% of the population, produces symptoms in 10% of the cases. More females in third and fourth decades is affected from this thoracic outlet syndrome by the cervical rib. Well musculature may predispose to the compress. Muscular person is may predispose to compression of this thoracic outlet and produce this syndrome. Fracture of the clavicle, that is the first rib. Now here is a picture showing the thoracic outlet obstruction of the arteries. Second image is clearly showing the cervical rib. Here is a schematic diagram of the anatomy of the thoracic outlet. There is a first rib and the scalenus medius and the brachial plexus in between the muscles, scalenus anterior and scalenus clavicles, comparably pressure these subclavian arteries, subclavian veins. Now the clinical features of this thoracic outlet syndrome is the neurological, is the pain, paresthesia and numbness is their symptoms. Signs, sensory and motor system should be examined, both fine and crude sensations, temperature and vibration, strength of muscles, muscle weakness or atrophy. Now the arterial compressions, due to the arterial compression, there is the pain, numbness, weakness and paresthesia and coldness of the limbs. Signs, differences between the qualities of the pulses, subclavian brachial, radial are compared with each other, pallor on elevation of the arm due to the poor blood supply, atrophy of the skin, brittle nails or ulceration, and on the venous compression, there is the symptoms like pain, edema, venous distension and cyanosis. Physical examination, three diagnostic manuals are on the rest. First is the Edson's manuals. This is, in this test, the patient sits on the stool. The clinician feels his radial pulse. The patient is now asked to inspire deeply, extend his head backwards and turn his chin towards the affected side. Deep inspiration, extension of the neck and turning of the head make the scalenus anticus muscles taut and may decrease or obliterate the radial pulse of the affected side. The test is said to be positive if there is a diminution of the or obliteration of the radial pulse and affected side. Second is the costoclavicular compression maneuver or the test. Patient radial pulse is felt. The patient throws his shoulders backward and downwards as an exaggerated military position. This will cause the reduction or disappearance of the radial pulse. This is produced by the compression of the subclavian artery between the clavicle and the first rib. Simultaneously, a subclavian bruit may be heard. And the third is the hyperabduction maneuver. Patient radial pulse is again monitored. The affected arm of the patient is now passively hyperabducted. This will cause the reduction or disappearance of the radial pulse due to the compression by the pectoralis minor tendon. The axillary bruit can be heard near the position of the pectoralis minor tendon. Now the differential diagnosis of this thoracic outlet obstruction is with the cervical spondylolisthesis, cervical disc protrusion, cervical cord compression, Pancoat's tumors, brachial neuritis, Raynaud's syndrome and carpal tunnel syndrome. With all these diseases, the thoracic outlet syndrome should be differentiated. Now the investigation has to be made in the like X-ray of the neck and chest to evaluate the bony abnormalities, that is the cervical rib, bifid first rib fusion of the first and second rib, clavicular deformities, narrowing of the intervertebral foramina by exostosis or the tumors, and third is the myelograms to demonstrate the protrusion of the cervical rib, cervical cord compression, arteriography to know or to detect the arterial compression, plethysmography, electromyographic study to establish the diagnosis of the neural compression to defect site of compression of peripheral nerves. Surgical treatment is excision of the cervical rib if present there, division of the scalenes anticus muscles, scalenotomy if the muscle is taut, resection of the clavicle if the clavicle compresses the thoracic outlet to the subclavian artery, division of the pectoralis minor tendon. This is the surgical treatment. Now the next point of this lecture is the Burgers disease, that is the TAO, means thromboangitis obliterans. This disease is described by the Winnie Waters in 1879 but published by the Leo Burgers in 1908 and 1924. Burgers disease means the inflammatory reaction in the arterial wall with the involvement of neighboring veins and nerve terminating in thrombosis of the arteries, occurring in 3rd, 4th, and 5th decades of the life. The men are more affected by the Burgers disease. Etiology: cigarette, due to the cigarette smoking, hormonal influence, lower socioeconomic group, poor hygiene, familial predisposition, autonomic overactivity, autoimmune etiology, and associated with the rickettsial disease. This is the typical image of the Burgers disease. Second image is showing the Burgers disease, bluishness, blackishness of the fingers. Now the pathology of the Burgers disease, that is the TAO, artery usually surrounded by the dense fibrotic reaction. Acute lesion consists of acute arteritis, periarteritis, acute phlebitis, periphlebitis. Vessel invaded by the polymorphonuclear leukocytes. Thrombosis occurs within the vessels with occlusion of the lumen. The thrombi contains the small abscess and the giant cells. Chronic lesions consist artery and vein bound together by the fibrous adhesions if nerve involves responsible for the agonism pain. Thrombus is the cause. Fibroblastic activity organized by the fibrous tissues, endothelial, proliferal proliferation becomes thickened. Now the clinical feature of the Burgers disease is the pain, foot claudication, intermittent claudication, pain increases when the muscle is exercised and the disappears when the exercise stops. Rest pain, pain at the rest, postural color changes, tropical changes, ulceration and gangrene is there and may be need of the amputation. Physical examination, inspection, sign on chronic tissue ischemia, atrophy of the skin, brittle nails, on the palpation, the pulse should be palpated there, the pulse should not be failed. Special initiation is the arteriography. Now the treatment is, first is the conservative treatment, stop the smoking if there is a smoking. Various drugs like vasodilator, anticoagulant, dexon, phenylbutazoline, steroid, prostaglandin therapy, that is the PGA1 to prevent the platelet aggregation. Surgical treatment is the sympathectomy, arterial reconstruction, but difficult, possible only in segmental occlusion, microvascular transplantation, free mental grafts, and amputation if there is a gangrene. Dear students, there are very good videos on the YouTube regarding this Burgers disease, thoracic syndrome, and the Raynaud's syndrome. You can watch it to clear and also refer the textbook to go in details of these points. And here is the end of our surgery lecture number 89, that is the Raynaud's disease and Burgers disease. Thank you.